In this video, we're going to go over the procedure for migrating the PIAF SQL database from one machine to another. The PIAF SQL database is one of two components of the PIAF server. The second component is the PIAF application service, which we will migrate in a later video. Let's say you have a simpler architecture such as this one, where the AF server and SQL server are both installed on the same machine, PIAF01. You would like to migrate the AF SQL database, also known as PIFD by default, to a different SQL server, SQL-NEW. The first thing you need to do is verify that SQL Server 2017 is compatible with PIAF Server 2018 SP2. You can do this by checking the SQL Server Requirements section of the AF Server release notes. In this case, the minimum SQL Server version is 2008, so we can go ahead and do the migration. To migrate the PIFD database, we'll need to take a full backup of it on PIAF01, restore the database backup on SQL-NEW, we'll recreate the AF server's local group on SQL-NEW and add the service account under which the PIAF application service is running to it. We'll rerun the go.bat against the restored PIFD database. This is to recreate the instance level objects such as maintenance and backup jobs. The go.bat script will also create a login for the AF server's local group and assign it all the necessary permissions of the database. Finally, we'll update the SQL connection string and the AF service config file on the AF server. Then we'll restart the PIAF application service so that it can connect to the new SQL server. Before taking a backup, we need to stop the PIAF application service to ensure that no more changes are made to the PIFD database. I'll go to services.msc and stop the service. All right, let's open SQL Server Management Studio, expand databases, right-click on PIFD, tasks, and select backup. We need to verify that the backup type is full and select the destination for the backup file. I'll leave the default location, but if you want to store the backup in a different location, you can click the Add option and navigate to the desired directory. All right, we're ready to take our backup. I'll go ahead and click OK. OK, the execution has been successful. Let's verify that we have a good backup and we can copy it over to the new machine. I've copied over the backup file from PIAF01 to SQL-NEW. And I'll restore it using SQL Server Management Studio. The instance we want to connect to here is SQL Express. Right-click on Databases, Restore Database, select Device, and we'll go and find the backup file, which is stored in C drive PIFD backup folder. I'll leave the database name as PIFD, but if you wanted to, you can change the database name to something else in this field. Let's go ahead and click OK to start the restore process. All right, looks good. The backup restoration process has been completed successfully. Normally, the AF server's local group is created by default when running the PIAF server installation kit. If the user running the installation kit has local admin privileges on the SQL Server machine, the installation kit also adds the account under which the PIAF application service is running to the AF server's group. Since we're only migrating the SQL database and not running the PIAF server installation kit, we will need to manually create the AF server's local group. If you do not wish to use the AF server's local group to grant access to the PIAF application service, you can create a login directly for its service account and map it to DB's AF servers. To create the AF server's local group, we can go to Computer Management and right-click the white space under Groups to create a new group. We'll call it AF servers and add the following description. I will now add the machine account for PIAF01 as the AF application service is not running under a service account. Before running the script, we can verify from SQL Server Management Studio that there is no login for the AFServers group. I'll run the following script from command prompt to execute the go.bat script against the PIFD database. The scripts have successfully executed. Let's go to SQL Server Management Studio to verify that there's now a login for the AFServers group and it's mapped to DB AFServers. We're back on PIAF01 and we're going to update the connection string with the new SQL Server name. We'll store that change and restart the PIF application service. Finally, we need to open PySystem Explorer to make sure that everything works fine and that we can connect to AF. All right, everything looks good. We can see that we're successfully connected to AF and our migration is now complete.